Good morning, girls. This is our second lecture of embedded operating system. Right? Last lecture we have seen. So last lecture we have seen introduction to the embedded operating system and the memory management, right? The function of operating systems are memory management that we have seen into the last lecture, how the CPU operating systems are managing the memories, what kind of process were there. Now this time we will take the process management, right? Now what is a process exactly? Process means it's a task, right? Complete your program, that is divide, that is a main process, right? And that process is divided into the sub tasks. So that is called as the process, and it is executed into the CPU. Now the process is the executions of a program, right? Process means what? It is the execution of a program. What are the parameters is required for that execution of program, right? That performs the action specified in that program, right? The process is the execution of program that performs the action specified in that program. So it can be divided an execution unit where a program can run. It can be defined in an execution unit, right? So each and every, who's managing this? Operating system. It is a task of operating system to manage the process, right? So which unit is managing the process? It is an execution unit is managing the process where the programs run, right? The operating system means whatever it is, general purpose or the embedded. What it is the role of the operating system? The operating system helps you create, as we have seen into the this our practical, to create, to schedule and to terminate the process which is used by CPU, right? So in the lab session we have seen how to create the process, right? So each and every, because that is the main program is there, but that program is divided into four tasks. So that four tasks is a four process, right? So the operating system is doing that work, right? It helps the operating system to create the task, to schedule the task, right? The whole process means whole CPU's work is managed by the operating system, and inside that operating system, it is a process unit is managing all these things, right? So create, schedule and terminate the process which is used by CPU, right? A process created by the main process is called as the child process, right? It is a main process because yesterday we have seen the example of the task one. We have created inside that the task two, and that is given the handler to delete that task, right? So inside the process, we are creating one process. That process is called as the child process, right? The process operation can be easily controlled with the help of process control box, right? So process control box is there, the information we can keep that whether this process is gone for the sleep mode or whether this process is activated, and then at what point the process is left to out of the CPU, which is the pointer of memory location, what are the variables of that process. So everything is managed by process control box, right? In process management, this is very, very important, process control box, right? Whenever we have created the process or the task, we have given specific amount of memories for that particular process, right? So in that particular process, pointer and informations, address, variable, everything, it will be stored into the process control box. Whenever the process is resumed to the next time, so it will take the information from the process control box and it start the executions, right? So according to that, suppose I'm just giving one example, your big process is there and task one is executing, right? And the task three has a highest priority and they are awake. So what if task one is half of the executed? So that pointer, that memory location, that variable, it will stored into the process control box, and the CPU will resume to the task three because task three has a highest priority than the task one, right? So and then let the finished task 3, and then again it will resume to the task 1, but it will not start from the beginning. It will start from where the process has left, right? Where the CPU has left the execution, it will start from there. So that is the very, very important in process management. It is a process control box block, right? It adds a brain of process. Yeah, right. We can say that it is a brain of process control block, which contain all the crucial information related the processing, like process ID, right? Priorities, status, and CPU register, right? It all the information, these are the very crucial information for the process. That is a process ID. Process ID means process address, right? We can say that the process address. Priorities, what process has the what priority, according to that it maintains the decision, it takes the decision of the CPU which task has to perform in an execution block, right, or execution unit. So the process ID, priority, status, and CPU register. CPU register means it is a value of your register. So it all our information is stored into the process control box, right? Now the process management. Process management involves various tasks like creation, scheduling, termination of process, right? So just now we have seen the creation and deletion of process. Deletion, it will not manage by the process. It is already deleted, memory will free, right? But the creation, scheduling means it is a priority which task has to perform, which process has to perform. Task means it is a process. Instead of task, you can give it to the name of process 1, process 2, process 3 also, right? Don't confuse process and a task for that particular program, right? The process management involves various tasks like creation, scheduling, and termination of process. And deadlock. Deadlock means it is a sleeping mode, right? So delay, it is called the deadlock. The process is program that is under execution, right? It is process is perform program. The process is a program that is under execution, right? Which is the important part of the modern day's operating system, because nowadays it is a multitasking operating system, right? It is not one task at a one time. It is a multitasking operating system, and then this is a role of a operating system. Nowadays all the embedded devices also in a multitasking, so that's why it is comes to the concept that the embedded operating system. Now that operating system has this role to manage the execution unit and the process. So the process is a program that is under execution, which is the an important part of the modern day's operating system, right? The operating system must allocate the resource that enable the process to share and exchange the information, right? Due to the multitasking, we shares the resources and they exchange the information, right? Suppose now this is the best example. I'm exchanging the information from here to there, right? By the same time, I have opened my email also. I am just giving a lecture also. PPT is also running. My audio is going. My video is going. So these all are the different tasks, right? So all these different tasks is managed by my computer operating system. Which process has to activate it and which process has to deactivate it. So this is the best example of operating system, right? It is sharing information. It is sharing resources also. One printer is I'm installing in my computer. Same printer can be installed to the other computer. That computer is also can take the printout. This computer, this laptop is also can take the printout. So that one computer is sharing with other. So that is one resources is sharing with other just due to the resource management or process management, right? So these are the, suppose simultaneously if I'm giving the print from my laptop and the print from my mobile also, but that the fraction of time my printer, my operating system will manage which has the first task and which has the second task. Automatically two printers will print out comes over there. So who is managing all this? This is a role of the operating system. So sharing the resources is one of the very, very important important factors in a operating system, because multiple resources we don't have to use if it is a common resource over there. So the allocated resources that enable the process to share, exchange information, it also protect the resource to each process from other methods and allow the synchronizations among the process. Just I have given the example. I have also given the print other mobile, from the other mobile also given the print, that is one one printer. So that printer drive or the package will manage, will synchro all among the all process. Printer from this laptop is also one process, printer from a mobile is also the another process that will synchro, and according to that it will take the decision and just will get the output according to that decision, right? So it is all managed by the process. It is synchronization among the process, right? It is a job of operating system to manage all running process of the system, right? It is the job of operating system to manage all running process, just keeping watch, that is called the watchdog timer. Abhi kiska process hua, abhi kon scheduling mein hai, all these done by the programming of operating system, right? It handles operations by performing the task like process scheduling, such as the resource allocation. Usko how to resource allocated, to which process has to allocated the resource. Suppose there is my program, I'm doing addition of two number, taking a data from the keyboard, right? So the process is execution, taking a data from keyboard. So the my process has to allowed the take the data from the keyboard. So input devices means my keyboard is the input, that is the resource. So that is shared with the process management. So the complete task means complete program is divided into the different tasks, and according to that task they will take the they will manage the resources. LCD screen is also one kind of resources. Audio mic is also one kind of resources. Keyboard is also one kind of resources. Mouse is also another kind of resources. All these managed by, all these are the process. Now I'm moving my mic, but simultaneously my audio is also going. So all these process are managed by operating system, right? So it is a job of operating system to manage all running process of a system. It's handle operation by performing the task like the process scheduling and such as the resource allocations, right? Now the process architecture, as yes, in last lecture we have seen memory stack there, right? So the same as either the text is there, data is there, heaps is there, and stack is there, right? So these are the process architecture, right? Text, data, heap, and stack, where we store the things. Now what is the stack? Stack stored the temporary data like a function, parameters, return address, and local variable, right? Return address means if any function is performing, the controller is goes to that perform, but it comes to the return. So where to return from, where from function, where to return into the main program? So that is called as the return address. The function parameters also stored, local variables is also there. When we are returning, we need that local variables value to execute the further process, right? So that is the work of the stack pointer, right? As you have learned, must be learned into the 8085, the stack is there. So we have a two instruction, push and pop. So we stored whenever our program counter moves to the subrouting. So that next memory location, it will stored into the stack pointer. So whenever we are using any call instruction in our program, we need to assign a stack pointer LXI SP and some memory location of stack pointer, because in that stack pointer our call, whenever we call the subroutine, so next pointer program counter address is stored into the stack pointer. After coming back to the subroutine, it will take the data, it will take the address from the stack pointer and it starts the execution of program, right? So that is a function of stack, right? Heap allocates the memory which may be processed during its runtime, right? This is very dynamic memory allocations, we can call it as. When the process is running and that time it's need any variables or it needs any memory location, so that time it is allocated, right? Stopwatch is there. So now it is incrementing one by one. So that now it is a 12.14. So next time it comes to the 12.41. So that 12.40 has to be stored in a dynamically. After one minute, it comes the 10.41. Then after 1 minute, it comes the 10.42. Right, so that is the dynamic memory allocations, we can call it as. So allocate the memory which may be processed during its runtime, because that is going on running and within that my data is changing, right? So that is my dynamic memory allocation, and heap memory is allocated for that memory which may be the process during the runtime, right? Agar timer clock ka agar mujhe kuch I have to do some program, so that time my timer is automatically incremented during the runtime. So that timer is running, so that data is storing, for that it is required a heap memory allocations, right? Data, it contains the all the variable, right? So there are the different tasks in our system, so all the tasks is divided into some process and all the tasks has some data, so all the task data is stored into the data block, right? And text means all the code. Text sections include the current activities, which is represented by the value of program counter, right? All the code, main code is stored into the text, right? And then a text of all the processes running into our CPU or running into our microcontroller, right? This is an embedded operating system, so we must be use the microcontroller. So all the processes running into our microcontroller, so all the code, all the programs are stored into the text, and all the variables are stored into the data. All the runtime memory allocations comes into the heap block, and all the temporary variable, return address, local variable, functions parameter are stored into the stack, right? These are the, now the important things is there into the process, that is a process control block, right? It's very, very important into the process control block, right? It is a data structure that maintained by operating system for every process. It is a data structure that is called as the data structure, right? Each and every information of that particular process, it is storing, that is called as the data structure, right? That maintains by the operating system for process, every process, right? It is the operating system are maintaining this process control block, right? Process control should be defined by the integer process, that is ID, PID. Also, it is called as the process integer process, right? Process ID. Also, it is called as the process ID. It is an integer, right? That process ID has an integer, that is called as the address of that particular process, right? It helps to store all the information required to keep off track, right? Track off. It stored all required information. Which information is stored? The process ID, temporary CPU register, process, process values, all this is stored into the required information of this, right? It is countable for storing the content of process register. So CPU register, process register is also stored there, counts there. There are saved when the process move from running state and the return back to it, right? There are saved all the information when the process are move from running state and then it return back to it, right? It is saved information if it is not running state mein hai, और उसके बाद में देन आफ्टर इट गोज टू द डिले स्टेट एंड अगेन इट इज कम बैक टू सो ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन आर स्टोर्ड इनटू द प्रोसेस कंट्रोल ब्लॉक राइट एंड दिस इंफॉर्मेशन इज क्विक अपडेट इनटू द प्रोसेस कंट्रोल बाय बॉक्स बाय एम्बेडेड ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम क्विक If it is taken, so just it will update into the process controller. It is into the delayer, just it will update into the process controller. So it is always backgrounds, it's running this program of process control block, right? It is storing into the block memory, right? As soon as the process make the status transition, all the running process, right? जैसे रनिंग से डिले में गया तो प्रोसेस कंट्रोल में इंफॉर्मेशन आएगा देन द प्रोसेस कंट्रोल विल मैनेज व्हेन द टास्क इज अवेक देन व्हेन द टास्क इज अवेक द सेम टास्क विल अवेक इनटू द सेम टाइम सो इट विल प्रोसेस कंट्रोल बैक ब्लॉक विल टेक द डिसीजन व्हिच हैज द हाईएस्ट प्रायोरिटी दैट टास्क हैज टू परफॉर्म द एग्जीक्यूशन सो ऑल दिस डन बाय द प्रोसेस कंट्रोल ब्लॉक दैट्स व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज द ब्रेन ऑफ द प्रोसेस मैनेजमेंट राइट सो होल द थिंग्स ऑफ द प्रोसेस इट विल मैनेज बाय process control box and it is into the embedded operating system right now we'll see the process status a process state is a condition of the process at a specific instant of time it is also defined as the current position of time it is also defined as a process status means what is the status of this process whether it is into the cpu execution unit whether it is into the memory unit whether it is into the sleep mode whether it is into the delay mode whether it is into the scheduling mode whether it is ready all these are the status of the cpu There are mainly seven stages of the process which are there are seven stages process right new process can be new and new can be block and new can be suspended no issue right it can be a block the first process it will create the new process can be blocked or new process can be suspended right after new it is a ready right ready then wait then execution then terminate After execution, it will be in a suspended mode, or it will be into the block mode, right? Or it is a terminated. Now the work is over and terminated. So these are the seven stages of the process: new, ready, wait, execution, terminated. This is one flow. Second flow: new can be block, new can be suspended, and execution mode can be block, can be suspended, right? So the block process can be block either new process or executing process can be suspended either the new or executing and terminate only executed process is a terminated no block process is terminated no suspended process is terminated right so these are the seven stages now the new process is create when a specific program calls from a secondary memory hard disk to the primary memory right now suppose if I'm saving a program I'm open a program so that is my program is stored into the hard disk and that is I'm opening that is called into the RAM memory so during that RAM memory this is a new process right that is a new process if I'm opening any program and that is already stored into the permanent memory and that opening means it is comes into the RAM so that is called the new process right the first transaction of that process is called the new process ready in ready state the process should be loaded into the primary memory which is ready for the executions right no delay mode nothing it is ready for the execution so that is called the ready stage right wait the process is waiting for the allocation of cpu time just I have created three tasks priority is given 1 2 3 now the task 3 is in a execution mode task 2 and 1 is in a waiting mode So that is called the waiting things, right? The process is waiting for the allocation of CPU time, other resources for execution. Other task is executing into the CPU, and the task 1 and task 2 are the waiting for the CPU. So that process is called the waiting CPU. The executing, the process is in an execution stage, right? Task 3 has a first priority. So task 3 is into the execution mode, but that time task 1 and task 2 are into the waiting mode, right? So that is called the waiting. Blocked, it is the time interval which the process is waiting for the event like IO operations to complete, right? Suppose if it is two tasks are there, and that task is waiting for the input and output devices. So that particular task is called the block task, right? And suspended means suspended state defines the time when the process is ready for the execution but not have been placed the ready queue by the operating system. Something is the given is there, just like my audio is not working. So that process is into the suspended mode. Let the audio is work. That is not into the ready queue. Now this ready queue, the operating system managed by queuing. That is also, we have one practicals, we will do it. So that time the process will stand into the queue, right? Just say when we go to the counter any for the inquiry. So we stand into the queue, and one by one we go to the counter, and then we solve our queries. The same as all the processes stored into the queue, and that according to that one by one it is executed. So suspended means what? Suspended state is defined the time when the process is ready for the execution but not into the place into the ready queue by the operating system. That task is suspended, right? The terminate state is specified the time when the process is terminated. Specified time, right? Suppose your task has given some 2 minutes, right? And then 2 minutes after it will terminate your process. That is called the terminated, right? After completing every steps, all the resources are used by process and the memory become free, right? After each and every process, if the process is from new to ready stage it goes, so new whatever the memory is allocated for the new process, that will memory and the process will free, right? That memory is free. After ready it comes to the execution mode, so whatever the memory is allocated for the ready, so that will free, that memory will free. So it is very important, after completing every steps, all the resources are used by the process and the memory become free, right? Suppose new stage I'm using my mouse or keyboard. After that it comes to the ready stage, so my keyboard will free for to use the another process, right? So all the resources, all the memories will free after each and every steps of the execution, right? Now process control block. Every process is represented in a operating system by the process control block. Every process is represented in the operating system by the process control block, which is called as the task control block. As I have told you, process and task is one thing, right? It is one. Task is a familiar word. Process is a computerized word, right? So here are the important components of a process control block. So process status, program counter, CPU register, CPU scheduling information, accounting and business information, memory management information, and input output stage, right? So these are the tasks of the process control box. Now process status. The process can be new, ready, run, wait. These all are the process status, right? So first is the process status. Process can be new, ready, wait, executions, whatever, right? All these 7 stages are the process stages, right? Program counter. Program counter, you must be familiar in 8085, the program counter, or your 8051. The program counter let you know that the address of next instruction which should be executed for that process, right? program counter is pointing to the address of the next instruction which to be executed. Now it is executing previous instruction, the next instruction has to be executed, right? That is a program counter. CPU register, these components includes the accumulator, index and all general purpose register informations of the condition code, right? So CPU register means it's a register. Say 8085 has a b c d h l stack pointer, program counter. So all these are the register general purpose. Microcontroller are r0, r1, r2, r3, r4, r7 for the bank of 4. So all these are stored into the CPU register, right? So CPU scheduling information, these components includes a process, priority, pointers for scheduling, queuing. So this is what the priority has. The process is scheduled according to their priority. It will manage the queue according to the priority of the process and various other scheduling parameters, handlers, then when to process delete, when to process create. So everything will manage into the schedule information, right? Accounting and business information. It includes the amount of CPU and the time utilized, like real time use, job and process number, right? Jobs or process, again one word is there, task, process, also it is called as the job, right? So don't confuse with this word, task, process and job, right? So account and business information, it includes the amount of CPU and the time, right? It will manage the time utilization of the real time. So it is managing the how much memory is used and how much time is used to execute this process. So time management, time accounting will be there into this process. Memory management information, right? A memory management information is also included into the process control block, right? This information includes the value of the base and limit register, pages, segments table, and this depend on the memory management and which is used by the operating system. All the stack memories will manage, or how much is the memory is left, how much is the, how to accommodate the registers, data, variables into the which block. So all this information is managed by the memory management information, right? Input output status information, this LCD screen, keyboard, mouse or mic, audio, all these are also the process, right? So these are all are the input output status information. This block includes the list of open file, list of input output devices and that are allocated to the process, right? List of open file, that is one process, because it is into comes from the hard disk to the RAM. So that is also manage input output, right? It is managing keyboards, it manage the LCD, it manage the mouse, it manage the speaker, it manage the headphones, mic, all these are managed by the input output. So these are the process management, process control block. Right, these are the parameter, these are the important components of the process control block, right? Now thank you girls, if you have any query just ask me. I will put this recording on our channel. Yeah girls.